Hey everybody, Jimmy here. I want to talk to you about something that can save you money on your health insurance bills. It's not insurance, it's impact health sharing. Let me tell you something. This is a solution for the healthcare crisis that I've been waiting for. It's not insurance, it's not socialized medicine, thank goodness. It's the best thing that's come down the pike. For more information about impact health sharing, contact an ACN distributor near you. God bless you. And there we go. Come on, Noah.
Leadership impacting in the American society.
They shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. They shine bright everywhere we go. They shine bright everywhere we go.
Leadership, vivacious and flashing with excellence.
Everywhere we go, they shine bright. Everywhere we go, everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people.
Here is an inspirational view of the political, of the social political landscape with a James A. Hendricks School of Leadership.
Good Wednesday, everybody. Hope everybody's staying warm. I'm not sure what your weather is like in other parts of the country. I kind of keep a limited skeptical eye of the news. But I'm looking out. I don't see any snow, but it is an icy desert patch here in West Texas. Now, I've been kind of looking forward to this day with awe and dread about what I'm, the one news item that I'm about to report on. And I want to apologize in advance, but this episode is going to be one of my rants. And I apologize for that. But in many ways, it needs to be said. Okay. I really didn't want it to come this way, but, well, I'm pretending to heart a guy, and I don't like being defiant or reactive or anything like that, but we're gearing up for 2024, and everybody's just ratcheting up the reactivity, and so I got to vent. Sorry. The topic is woke corporates and big tech. Now, I know that this is going to piss some people off. This is going to make some people angry. And I'm liable to be censored. I know that. But now, let me qualify myself. I'm not going to talk about the 2020 election. I'm not going to talk about January 6th. Yes, those were travesties in my life, okay? But my idea of analyzing the news is let's move forward, okay? Can we move forward? And the thing is, I don't think that these woke corporates are, or that they will, or that they have any inclination to do so. No. And you might say, but why? My best friend and I were sitting talking politics and business and other spirituality matters late into the night last night. Well, he went to bed around, I guess, 2-ish or something. Camping out, I guess. But we were talking. He said, what is it that makes these woke liberal corporations? I said, usually text somebody on the board who is a millennial, is doing all these studies, you know, crunching numbers, Lord knows what else, and they decide that woke is the way to go. And I named a few, and I'm not gonna name them on the podcast. I'm gonna leave it up to you to rant in your homes, among your friends and your family. because I could name them. But then that would just make me even more angry, okay? I'm angry enough as it is since 2020. If you ask me, maybe even more since 2018. And no, Donald Trump didn't anger me. I've been looking at the 7 candidates that are running against Trump, and right now, I have to say Trump is the best one. A lot of these, let's look at the governor of Virginia, Youngkin. Because I don't think our next president should be a career politician. Now, don't get me wrong, Youngkin is 4 years older than me. Okay, so I'm going to look at his record. He's only in his second year as governor. Alright, so I'm not going to criticize that. Now, if I can find it, I'm going to look at his curriculum vitae. Okay, you know, excuse me, but I think we should evaluate. We should evaluate who's going to be our president. Wait, something. He went to Rice University. Okay, that's commendable. And then he went to Harvard. Now look, I'm not downing Harvard. Because there was a time back in the early 80s as a teenager, I told Mama I wanted to go to Harvard, and she said no. So I'm happy to say that the one thing that kept me out of Harvard was my dear sweet Mama. I'm going to share this episode live and say, Mama, I love you. Thank you for changing my mind. And you and Granddad influencing where I should get my education. Now, Youngkin's a good candidate for Trump. Now, I'm going to support Trump no matter what, because I really don't know that much about Youngkin. Okay. Ron DeSantis. Don't get me wrong. I love Ron DeSantis. But if you ask me, he should stay on as governor. Or he should consider being like an influencer in Congress again or something. Now, say something happened where Trump couldn't campaign. Now, I have to be honest with you. I would be behind. I would be behind Ron DeSantis because he's in my generation. There's some conservative Gen X. We finally get it. But you got these woke corporations, okay? And they got ideas that we conservatives are really capitalists. That all, you know, we got woke training in schools. We're training our kids that all business is bad. Yeah, well, what about the big brands of woke corporates that are censoring conservatives? Once again, I'm not gonna name names. I'm not a reactive, distractive, defiant prattler, okay? May hear banter, you know, among friends and stuff, but when it comes to discourse and I hear that senseless prattling, Oh, I didn't want him to come out, but I guess he will. I hear senseless prattle about what's going on with these woke corporates, and I start getting mad. It's JR. You don't want JR mad, you hear me? You don't want him mad. Now, normally I'm a pussycat, but I'm starting to get angry. There used to be a time that we protected our properties. We respected one another's properties and values. I'm sad to say, I think some of that's gone by the wayside. And it drives me crazy, and I hope it drives you crazy, too. Okay, Tara, enough. All right, listen to me, guys. I wasn't expecting that to happen, and I apologize, but it's part of my rant. Okay? Because of woke corporates, we have a lack of respect of what's going on in this country. Big tech and woke corporates, Congress should investigate these people and use the bureaucratic agencies that they've created to hold their feet to the fire. I don't care who's in power, as long as we get justice for the American people and get freedom back in this country. Now with that, I hope you enjoy listening to the James H. Hendrick School of Leadership. If you like what you hear, please subscribe and become a part of the James A. Hendrick School of Leadership Classroom. Tomorrow's Constitution Thursday, we're going to be dealing with Article 2, so get ready. This is Jimi Hendrick saying, until next time, Jesus saves, and we're all going to be okay. Keep up the hope, keep up the faith, take care, and be proactively informed. God bless each and every one of you. God bless you.